Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are safe at your home with good hygiene. Okay, let's start today's video. Students, in previous video, I taught you the story writing and I gave you one question for completing the story also. Today, I would discuss with you the second and third type of the story writing. Students, now I'm writing a question on the board. Please note it down from here. Okay students, this is the second type of story writing which I am going to discuss with you all today. Students, firstly I discussed with you all the types. As I told you, in the first type we only find the beginning of the story, okay, and this is the second type. Here we have found the outlines. It means we have found these outlines with the gaps in between. Okay, now you can see Kunal, gaps, good students, gaps, determined, gap, scored good marks, gap, examination, gap, got late, gap, helping an old man, gap, teacher, scolded, gap, letter appreciated, gap, gave exam, gap, stood first. Okay students, now you have to think what is going on. It means you need to understand what is going on in this story. Then you will make a story in your mind, then you will start writing. Okay, now in this story your starting and your ending both are completely settled. You cannot change any word or any sentences from here. Okay, as in the first time only the beginning is given. And we have to start writing from that beginning, and we have to continue that and then finish the story with the same ideas, with the same thing. Okay, now here in first time you are free to use your own word in the mid and till end. Okay, but now here you are not free in the beginning and not in the end. Okay, it doesn't mean students that gaps have been given here and you will fill the words in these gaps. No, it doesn't mean. Okay, you have to think what is going on here, make a story in your mind, then start writing from Kunal and end is to first. Okay, now see students, Kunal good students, it means Kunal was a good student and he was determined. It means he was having firm faith in himself, he was having a firm decision in himself, and as he was a good student, he always scored good marks in the class. Everyone, along with the parents and teachers, everyone was very happy from Kunal. Okay, and now the examinations were going on. And unfortunately Kunal got late for reaching his school. Now the question arises, why he got late for reaching his school? Because in the way, when he was coming to school, in the way, he saw an old man, a helpless old man, and somewhere he thought to help that person first. As he was a very innocent, very sincere student, so he decided to help that old man first, and then after he, after completing that old man, he came to the examination center. So generally students, he had to be late for reaching school because he passed some time for in the help of old man. So surely it was the genuine reason he got late for his school. But when he reached his school, his teacher scolded, even got angry on him, and he scolded him also because for being late. But when Kunal discussed everything, whatever was happened with him in the way, so when he discussed each and everything with the teacher, his teacher not only became happy, he appreciated also, okay, and he permitted Kunal for sitting in the exam, and even after having a shortage of time, lack of time, Kunal performed so well, again he scored good marks and he again came first in the, not only in the class, but in the whole school, in the complete school. So students, this is the story which I have discussed with you today, and it doesn't mean the story which I have discussed you will write. You can think your own ideas, you can think your own problems complete this story or to complete the word limitation of the story. And one more thing students, which I did not discuss with you in the previous video, that was after completing the story, you need to give a particular title to your story, and you need to write that on the top of your story, and at the end of the story you need to write a moral. It means what you have learned from your story. Okay, so students, this is the second type. In the first type, I wrote only the beginning, or in the second type, we have find the outlines with the gap in between. And now I am going to discuss the third type of the story writing. It means that is the picture description. Students, in this type, we always find a picture, and on the basis of that picture, we have to write a story. Now I am going to show you the picture. Please notice it carefully. Okay students, I hope the picture is completely visible and clear to you. Now you have to think what is going on in this picture, where the couple is going, what's the problem the couple is facing, and you have to think. In this picture, in this third type of story writing, you are completely free. You are completely free for writing. Beginning is yours, middle is yours, and the end also is yours. Okay students, you have to think, you have to make a story after observing this picture in your mind, and you have to start writing. Okay students, so in this way, your three types of the story writing have been completed today. Now these are the two questions which you have to write again in your fair notebook of English second class 10th. Okay students.